Good morning, Eisenhower. I'm your host, Zach, along with
Michael. Today is May 14th, Day A.
Today in history, on May 14th, 1607, Jamestown, Virginia is settled as an English colony.
And now for the Spanish and Latin America Fact of the Week.
Did you know that Argentina is the home to the world's most famous soccer player, Lionel Messi? Lionel Messi started playing soccer when he was 3 years old. He plays for Argentina, but his club team is in Spain.
Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. And now for today's announcements with Allison
and Lauren.
Good morning, I'm Allison along with
Lauren. What does today's weather look like?
Today, mostly cloudy with temperatures warming rapidly into the middle 60s. Tonight, cloudy, low of 59. Tomorrow, overcast, high of 78 degrees. Now here's Lauren with today's announcements.
Thank you, Allison. The boys beat FAMS yesterday. Casey pitched a complete game and added a double. John had a triple that scored 2 runs. The boys play Montvale on Friday. Congrats to the girls' softball team on their win against Franklin Lakes yesterday. Andy pitched the whole game and only gave up 2 runs while striking out 5 batters. Lauren made a great play in center field and had 3 hits, including a home run. Ashley also had a home run in the 6th inning. Lauren added 2 hits while scoring 3 runs. Jess and Shannon split the time behind the plate to help the team earn their 5th win of the season. Come out and support their next home game Friday against Montvale. Go Generals. Calling all students. Next Tuesday, there will be a special opportunity for 8th graders during their lunch period, lunch and lunges. Ramapo High School fencing team members will be in the multipurpose room to demonstrate the exciting sport of fencing. Attention 7th grade band students, we will meet today during period 2 for rehearsals. The Summer Excella program, under the direction of Mrs. Weissman, would love to have Eisenhower volunteers to help with Safety Town and Wonderful Fun. If you are interested, please contact Mrs. Weissman or Miss Laverty. The program will be held at Lincoln School from July 7th to August 1st. We would appreciate any help you can provide. You will receive community service for your efforts. Attention track and field members. There is no track practice today. Be ready for tomorrow's meet at Riverdale, where we will also be competing against Hohokus. Here's Allison with the rest of today's announcements.
Advisory is on Friday this week, so Phys Ed, Open Lab, Art, Home Ec, and World Language Thai classes are available today. Attention student council members going on the NJASC trip tomorrow. Be at school by 6:50 a.m. We don't want to leave without you, but we will. We're looking forward to a great trip. The 7th grade canteen is going to be this Friday, May 16th at 7:30 to 9:30 p.m. Doors open at 7:20 p.m. No early admittance permitted. To all 7th graders, come have fun with your friends at the last canteen for the year. REACT is having their annual car wash on this Saturday, May 17th from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. Please have your family come down and have their car washed. All proceeds will go to the Wyckoff Fire Department. Come to the Rampo High School Cheerleading Interests Meeting on Tuesday, May 20th at 6:30 p.m. The meeting is in the Ramapo High School Health Room. Attendance at this meeting is mandatory if you're interested for trying out for the team. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Yes, Allison. Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Emily in 8F. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is homemade assorted calzones. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is Cool Ranch Chicken Twister.
What's in the headlines?
The National September 11th Memorial Museum at Ground Zero is finally opening this Thursday with President Obama. The museum will officially open to the public next Wednesday. And now for today's feature with Jeremy
and Timmy.
Thank you, Lauren and Allison. Today we're here with Mr. Ramo and Jake, and they're going to talk about Coder Dojo.
So Mr. Ramo, I hear you're running a Coder Dojo at Sycamack School, where you are the principal. That sounds pretty interesting, but what exactly is a Coder Dojo?
Yeah, so like a dojo for martial arts, if you know about that, that's where you go to practice martial arts. So Coder Dojo is really cool. It's an international coding club. It started in Ireland about 2 years ago, but now it's in over 40 countries, and there are over 350 dojos worldwide. And Sycamack School has the only Coder Dojo in Bergen County in a school, so it's, you know, it's cutting edge, and it's really cool.
Who can join the Sycamack Coder Dojo?
Yeah, anybody. We started out just for Sycamack kids, and I wanted to see if there was demand. And we've had 3 sessions so far. They're on Saturdays. And actually, we get like 20 to 25 kids to come out and code and program games and animations on Saturday from 10 to 12. It's volunteer. You come if you want. Don't come. It's up to you. But anybody can come now. I'm opening up to the whole district. And I think there are a lot of kids who love computers and who love to see computers do what they want rather than, you know, just typing, right? So when you code, you make the computer do what you want, and that's what coding and programming is all about, and the Coder Dojo gives kids practice doing that.
How can Eisenhower students who are interested in coding help out?
Well, this guy right here can tell you about that. He was one of our first Coder Dojo mentors, and what we're going to do at the dojo is give middle school kids like Jake a chance to go help the younger students learn. So why don't you tell them a little bit about what you did?
Well, we would go up to them and we would ask them what their problem was. Yeah. And instead of just doing it for them, we helped them along with it and did it with them.
Yeah, and do you think that helped them?
Yeah, it helped them a lot. It wasn't just, you know, telling them what to do and having them do it and not learning at all.
Yeah. The little kids, you know, the elementary kids look up to you guys. So if I can get more middle school kids to come and show them how to do it, it's going to grow like wildfire.
What do coding mentors from Eisenhower do at the Coder Dojo?
Well, coding mentors, we help kids code on Scratch so they can make their own programs. Lots of times we use different strategies, like I said before, like asking them on how they want to learn or what their problem is. And instead of telling them what to do, we show them step by step how to do it.
Awesome.
Does working as a Coder Dojo mentor help us earn community service hours?
Absolutely. So if you need community service, if you serve as a mentor, I'll be happy to sign anything. You get 2 hours or 1 hour. Stay as long as you want or as little as you want.
What if students want to learn more about coding instead of mentoring?
You can come and just code if you want. We have 2 more sessions left. Saturdays, like May 31st and June 14th. If you're curious, touch base with Mr. Oliar. She can put you in touch with me.
Why is coding something you feel is so important?
You know, just think about how computers are taking over, right? And how phones are as popular in apps. We don't have enough college students who know how to write program. So if kids are exposed to it in an early age, even in elementary school, I think the U.S. will be in a better position for, you know, having the computer science industry filled by our people, right? You know, writing programming code for whatever we need. It's also a lot of fun, right?
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for having me.
And now
tomorrow's features on the Avengers.
And now back to our hosts, Michael
and Zach.
Thank you, Timmy and Jeremy.
Thanks for watching, Eisenhower.
Have a Clan War Wednesday.